Welcome to worship. I am Bishop Regina Hassanali, here with Assistant to the Bishop, Reverend Emily Carson, and it is our great delight to lead you through a Synod-offered worship service this morning. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all, and also with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, you sent Jesus to illumine the world with your light. By your grace, enlighten us with your Spirit, through Jesus Christ, our Redeemer and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Love has come and light in the darkness. Love. This reading comes from Isaiah 52, 7 through 10. How beautiful on the mountains are the feet of those who bring good news, who proclaim peace, who bring good tidings, who proclaim salvation, who say to Zion, your God reigns. Listen, your watchmen lift up their voices, together they shout for joy. When the Lord returns to Zion, they will see it with their own eyes. Burst into songs of joy together, you ruins of Jerusalem, for the Lord has comforted his people. He has redeemed Jerusalem. The Lord will lay bare his holy arm in the sight of all the nations, and all the ends of the earth will see the salvation of our God.
Greetings, members of the Southeast Minnesota Synod of the ELCA. My name is Lisa Dirks, a member of your Synod Council, as well as a congregational member at Trinity Lutheran in Wanamingo. I will be reading Psalm 98 for us. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. His right hand and his holy arm have worked salvation for him. The Lord has made his salvation known and revealed his righteousness to the nations. He has remembered his love and his faithfulness to Israel. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation of our God. Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Burst into jubilant song with music. Make music to the Lord with the harp and the sound of singing, with trumpets and the blast of the ram's horn. Shout for joy before the Lord the King. Let the sea resound and everything in it, the world and all who live in it. Let the rivers clap their hands. Let the mountains sing together for joy. Let them sing before the Lord, for he comes to judge the earth. He will judge the world in righteousness and the peoples with equity.
A reading from Hebrews, the first chapter. Long ago, God spoke to our ancestors in many and various ways by the prophets. But in these last days, he has spoken to us by his Son, whom he appointed heir of all things, through whom he also created the worlds. He is the reflection of God's glory and the exact imprint of God's very being, and he sustains all things by his powerful word. When he had made purification for sins, he sat down at the right hand of the Majesty on high, having become as much superior to angels as the name he has inherited is more excellent than theirs. Here ends the reading.
Hi, I'm Pastor Colette Brody Grund here in Mankato with my colleague, Pastor Erica Kozer, and Schnitzel. Puppy Schnitzel is joining us today, too. We're going to tell you a little bit about the ministry that we have here in Mankato called Connections Ministry. But before we do that, I want to remind you of this story. You might even have this Bible at your house. But you can see Jesus' mom there on the donkey with her little buddy, and she is almost ready to have a baby. And remember when they get to Bethlehem, where they were going to be with their family, then they need to have the baby. But there's nowhere for them to stay. Do you remember that? And they knock on all the doors and everybody says, sorry, we're all full. And they keep going until finally somebody gives them a stable, a place to stay with all the animals, and that's where Jesus is born. And they lay him in the manger, which is the place the animals eat from, and that's his first bed. Well, we've been thinking a lot about that stable and that first bed here at Connections this Christmas.
Connections Ministry provides a bed for people who may have been knocking on lots of doors but don't have a place to stay. And Connections gives them a bed and a pillow and a meal at night so that they can sleep safely and have a full belly and feel loved and taken care of when they come and stay with us at Connection Shelter. And we do that because we believe that Jesus wants us to provide a place of welcome and a place of safety for our neighbors who need it, just like he needed it when he was a baby. And so we do this work because we think that Jesus calls us to do that. If you want to know more about what we do at Connections Ministry, we have a great website that is connectionsshelter.org. You can find out all about the work that we do and even come and see it for yourself. We would love to have you join us to volunteer or just come check it out and see what having room for everyone looks like at Shelter. All right, will you join us for a prayer? Fold our hands so we don't get distracted. And remember, we say amen at the end of our prayers, right? Okay, let's pray. Dear God, thank you for that innkeeper who answered Mary and Joseph's knock and gave them a place for Jesus to sleep. Be with all of our neighbors who don't have a safe place to sleep this Christmas. And bless all of those who offer beds, especially the work of Connections Ministry. And all God's people said, amen. Amen. Thanks for joining us.
Today's gospel reading is from the Gospel of John, chapter 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. Here ends the reading. Beginnings are important. Where we start a story shapes its meaning. Christmas isn't the beginning. Christmas is a continuation of an eternal story. That's where the Gospel of John begins. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. John invites us, right from the start of his account of Jesus, into a cosmological imagination. He doesn't start by orienting us to a particular geographic place. He doesn't identify a particular intended audience either. Instead of zooming way in on the details of Jesus' birth, John zooms way out. It's like John leads us, his hearers, out into the woods on a clear night and then says, "Look up," to a sky full of stars. The story starts here. The Gospel of John is the story of Jesus' life, death, and resurrection, and it's also the story of the birth of creativity and humanity and existence. Interestingly, for a book about Jesus, John doesn't even use Jesus' earthly name until verse 17 of chapter 1. Instead, he refers to Jesus as the Word, or in the original Greek, Logos. Right off the bat, John invites his hearers into a new way of hearing, thinking, and being. Perhaps we might benefit from a similar reorientation to the world around us. Can we zoom way out from the dynamics of this complicated, challenging year for a moment and find our way back to the beginning of the beginning? Can this Christmas season be an invitation to look up and look around in a new way? What might we notice from a different perch? John, in these first few verses of the gospel, describes an infinite, eternal thread that runs through all existence. He calls this thread Logos, the Word. Everything is woven into being through this thread, and nothing that exists is outside the Word. He says that the Word is life, and this life is a light for all humanity. Christmas, the story of Jesus' birth, isn't the beginning. It's a continuation of a story that stretches all the way backward and all the way forward. Christmas is an important chapter of an ongoing story of a God who brings possibility into being. The way John describes Logos is not like a traditional commentary on a human person. There is no reference to the size or stature or status of Logos. Instead, John describes Logos like a force. Logos is at work in every moment of every day, in every life. This is where John starts the story of Jesus. Before there was an infant in a manger, there was a word. And that word changed everything. That word brought and still brings everything into being. People of God, as you look up and look around, as you look in and look out, what do you notice? Where have you experienced the word that is the light of all humanity? 2020, for all its wounds and complications, has also been a year in which the light continued to shine. We see things that we didn't see before. We feel things that we didn't feel before. It's hard and it aches. There's tension, there's injustice, there's hurt in our individual households and in our families, in our churches, and in our world. We all know deep down that 2020 isn't the beginning of the story of all this brokenness. The heaviness of this year didn't just appear when the first Minnesotan contracted coronavirus or when the mandatory shutdowns began in March. A lot of what's hard and broken and uncomfortable is systemic and all tangled together. Political turmoil, racial injustice, economic inequity. 2020 isn't the beginning of these stories. The word, the light, has empowered us this year to see more clearly what was already there. And this seeing equips us to act and live in new ways. Noticing what has been illuminated this year has given many a chance to reimagine how we do life, how we do church, how we spend money, and how we are together. Congregations have said yes to worshiping and living together in new ways. People have said yes to being family and loving neighbor in new ways. We won't stop here. We will continue on, and we will do so knowing that this moment is an opportunity to practice what the Word, the Logos, has been authoring all along. Lives and faith communities rooted in justice, mercy, humility, and love. John's telling of the Christmas story begins with the word. This word has always been and will always be. It's around us and within us. It's in you, right now in 2020 and always. The story didn't start here, and it won't stop here either. Look up, look around, look in, look out. There is nothing outside the reach of the word. The word that is ever illuminating, the word that is always breathing life, the word that forever grants hope to the weary. May you know, trust, and experience the word made flesh. May your congregation know, trust, and experience the word made flesh. And may this word, this perspective granter, this Jesus, forever remain the center of our Christmas and the center of our lives. Amen.
The Word of God fleshed out among us. The Word of God fleshed out among us. Justice, we long for justice. We long for the Word of God fleshed out among us. The light of life shining into our world. The light of life shining into our world. justice. We long for the light of life shining into our world.
Good morning. My name is Ann Peterson, and I serve as the Synod's Vice President. I bring you Christmas greetings on behalf of the Synod Council. Thank you for your continued partnership in ministry. We give thanks for you and for how you continue to share the love of Jesus in creative and compassionate ways. We've now transitioned to the offering portion of today's worship service. We have much for which to give thanks as we offer our gifts today. We especially thank you for your courage, resourcefulness, and willingness to adapt in the face of uncertainty. Today, as you worship, we encourage you to make a financial gift in support of the ministries of your local congregation. The compassion of Jesus continues to be poured out on a local level through the ministries of your congregation. A portion of the gifts you share with your local congregation are extended to support the ministries of the synodical and churchwide expressions of our denomination. The story of Christmas is a story of a God who enters into the complexities of life and offers hope. You've continued to share the hope of Jesus throughout 2020, and for that we are grateful. Thank you for being part of the Southeastern Minnesota Synod, and thank you in advance for your generosity.
With the whole people of God in Christ Jesus, let us pray for the church, those in need, and all of God's creation. Emmanuel, God with us, we pray for your church throughout the world, that the promises of Advent, hope, peace, love, and joy, made known in the birth of Jesus, would indeed be markers of your church and your people for the sake of your glory. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Creator of the stars of night, creator of all things, we pray you would continue to sustain your good creation and grant us, your people, the wisdom and courage needed to steward the good gifts you give. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God who comes near to us and is close to us in all things, we pray especially for the poor, the oppressed, the sick, the bereaved, and the lonely. Spirit, stir us up to be a people who care for one another with tenderness and love. Help us to be your presence among those who suffer in any way. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We celebrate the birth of Jesus in these days, the miraculous gift of God with us and among us. Be with all who suffer in mind, body, or spirit. Make us a people unafraid to walk alongside each other in all circumstances. Sustain us with your goodness and grace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For the Southeastern Minnesota Synod and your people here, God grant us courage, wisdom, compassion, and care. Spirit, transform us and use us. May we be as a city on a hill pointing others to you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Gracious God, you are loving in all things. We offer you our adoration and praise, thanksgiving and joy for all you have done, all you are doing, and will yet do among your people in this place. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Into your gracious hands, God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Gathered into one, we pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who have trespassed against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Hello, my name is Diana Parks, and I serve at Good Earth Village. Please join me in singing Away in a Manger.
Down his sweet head, the stars and the bright sky looked down where he lay. The little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay. The cattle are lowing, the poor baby wakes. The little Lord Jesus, no crying he makes. I love thee, Lord Jesus, look down from the sky and stay by my cradle till morning is nigh. Be near me, Lord Jesus, I ask thee to stay close by me forever and love me, I pray. Bless all the dear children in thy tender care, and take us to heaven to live with thee there.
Merry Christmas.
Dear people of God, rejoice, for Jesus, Emmanuel, God with us, has come. May this same God be near to you in all things. May the joy of our salvation be steadfast in the days and weeks ahead. And may the Spirit of the Lord dwell in us for the sake of God's work in the world. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Go in peace.
Rejoice in the Word made flesh.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.